Welcome to a proof of the derivative of f of x equals arc cosine x. We'll prove the derivative of arc cosine x with respect to x equals negative 1 divided by the square root of the quantity 1 minus x squared. So to begin, we'll let y equal arc cosine x. We'll notice how here x would be the cosine function value and y would be the angle. Then it follows that cosine y equals x, where the angle y would be on the closed interval from 0 to pi. And because we have cosine y equals x, if we want x over 1, let's model the angle y using a triangle, where we know that the cosine function value is equal to the ratio of the adjacent side to the hypotenuse. So using this right triangle and labeling this angle y, we can label the adjacent side x and the hypotenuse 1. And therefore, using the Pythagorean theorem, we can label the opposite side the square root of the quantity 1 minus x squared. So we know cosine y equals x. Now we also know that sine y equals the ratio of the opposite side to the hypotenuse, which simplifies to the square root of the quantity 1 minus x squared. However, we should recognize that if the angle y is in the first quadrant, cosine y will be positive and x will be positive. But if y is in the second quadrant, then cosine y will be negative, so the x value would be negative. And also, because sine y would always be positive when the angle is in the first and second quadrant, we know the square root of the quantity 1 minus x squared would always be positive. Now for the next step, we'll take the equation cosine y equals x and differentiate both sides with respect to x. So this will require implicit differentiation. So now we have the derivative of cosine y with respect to x equals the derivative of x with respect to x. And the derivative of cosine y with respect to x is equal to negative sine y times dy dx, which is equal to the derivative of x with respect to x, which is 1. And now solving for dy dx, we would divide both sides by negative sine y. So we have dy dx equals 1 divided by negative sine y. So we know our fraction or our derivative function value is going to be negative. And we know that sine y is equal to the square root of the quantity 1 minus x squared. And therefore, we know that dy dx equals negative 1 divided by the square root of the quantity 1 minus x squared. And we have our proof. So notice how the derivative function value will always be negative where it's defined. Notice how it would not be defined at x equals 1 or negative 1 because we'd have division by 0. But because the derivative function value is always going to be negative where it's defined, we know the slopes of the tangent lines to y equals arc cosine x will be negative where the derivative is defined, and the function is also going to be decreasing where the derivative is defined. And let's verify this graphically before we go. So here's the graph of f of x equals arc cosine x, and notice how for wherever the derivative is defined, the slopes of the tangent lines would be negative, and the function is decreasing. I hope you found this helpful.